Hello, everyone. I'm afraid you heard that correctly. Name is Rex. Apparently being ginger wasn't enough of a target, so my parents gave me a dog's name. Often I'm asked what's it short for, at which point I look down in shame and insist I'm a grower, not a shower. I am, in fact, neither. I'm in one of those same-sex relationships. Yeah, not gay, just the sex is always the same. Fortnightly 5 minutes of missionary in the dark, after which she asks, what's it short for? Promised my girlfriend I wouldn't make that joke. After all, it's not entirely true. Never lasted 5 minutes. She's a difficult woman to please, and not just in that sense. Never quite living up to her expectations. The other day, she asked for tickets to see Hamilton, so I took her to the F1. Won't tell you what I did when she asked to see Fiddler on the Roof, but the neighbours weren't best pleased. She and I have moved to the countryside, which has taken some getting used to. The train is slightly longer than the tube. It's 12 carriages instead of 8. Then, of course, there's the cultural difference. There's this bizarre unspoken rule where in the countryside you must say hello to strangers as you pass them. Less of a hello, more of a nervous pant. Hi. Hi. Word of advice, if any of you are planning a visit to the countryside, that rule doesn't extend to the local supermarket. Apparently you're scaring the customers, and could you please put some trousers on, sir? And while we're here, what's it short for? I do love the countryside, though. It's encouraged me to start running. Got myself a Garmin, which is apparently a contraceptive as well as a smartwatch. I've been commended for my runner's physique, which seems to just be a polite way of saying you look malnourished. Believe it or not, though, I am sporty, or certainly was. I used to play rugby, as you can probably tell by my voice. I say play. I was the posts. Sorry. So running's one of my better habits. One of my slightly worse habits is vaping. I'm an absolute sucker for a vape. You know, the vapes, the disposable ones, they seem to replace Call of Duty and wanking as the latest dopamine hit for teenagers. I'm trying desperately hard to ditch the habit, so I've turned to a book, and it lists all the wonderful ways in which we form habits and how we can break them. And one of these suggestions is replacing one habit with another. And it's worked an absolute treat. Now, every time I have the urge to vape, I reach for a pack of Marlboro Golds instead and work my way through those. Thank you very much for listening, and I'm still yet to last 5 minutes.